Nothing gets past Lizzie Jelfs, Eagle Eye.
I'm going with White Moss on top. I had her on top last start and she just bungled the start, and she seems as though she's a bit more settled, the barrier blanket today, and she's definitely returned in nice order. She's very fit, very healthy.
White Moss still in front, clings on. White Moss wins the Millie Fox, and great tipping by Lizzie Jelfs there from the mounting yard.
That's an amazing tip from Lizzie.
That's why she's the best in the business. Last week she tipped a $19 winner off a 25 length defeat. This week, well done Lizzie, $61 when she tips it.
I'm going with Top Striker on top. He's a really fit, healthy horse. He's carrying nice condition. He loves these types of rain-affected going, and he's got beautiful dapples going all the way through his coat. So I think he can run really nicely at each way odds.
Top Striker goes after Goldfinch, and Top Striker goes home best. And Lizzie Jelfs has done it again.
Oh, doesn't she love a promo? They'd better get another one ready. Lizzie's found another one at 50-1.
I think pick of the yard, I'm going a bit wide in this. I'm going to go with Sam Adapt because he just looks ready to go. He's really fit. He's really healthy.
Sam Adapt, a big leader from Happy Clapper. Invincible Gem Andavilius. Sam Adapt still in front. 50 out. Sam Adapt. Sam Adapt causes the boil over. Leads all the way on the wing stakes.
Sam Adapt. I want to go back and check the tape and make sure Lizzie really tipped that. $40.70 and $6.70. Well done, young lady. You've tipped a 40-1 winner in a Group 1.
Greg, I'm going with Ghostly on top. Obviously, those comments from David Pfeiffer were not necessarily encouraging, but as far as condition is concerned, he's done plenty of work and he should be able to be effective first up.
Ghostly at the 100, getting through Broken Arrows with a huge run late. Broken Arrows after Ghostly. I think it just missed.
Oh, the faithful have been rewarded, I think. Queen Lizzie's done it again.
Welcome to Women in Racing, a chance to highlight the inspirational achievements of females in this great sport.
You've not only inspired women in the industry, but you've also inspired women in business as well, because you've been so highly successful in your field. How does that make you feel?
You know, she's probably about five. She had all the tubes for no hair, and I was like, she had cancer, and I was like, she's 5 years old.
Katie Page has been a pioneer in business, not only through her exploits as CEO of Harvey Norman, but also through the growth of the Magic Millions. Thank you, Ziva. Hi, Ziva. Ziva! You actually said you thought she could win the Everest.
I don't think you like her very much.
I don't get the buzz.
You got upset with me yesterday when I started saying winks or something, and you got very upset with me.
Yeah, I just think I haven't been taken over by the hysteria of her. I don't think...
Is there hysteria?
Yes, definitely with my colleagues. And this colleague in particular. Thank you, Richard. Yeah, it's wonderful to be here at Royal Ascot, the most prestigious race meeting in the world. Well, I'm joined by Aidan O'Brien, the winner of the Diamond Jubilee with Merchant Navy, and it was a fantastic performance. There's lots to look forward to throughout the week, but especially today is one of the best days racing here on the English calendar. Welcome to the extended coverage of Rose Hill Trials this morning. We're all here to see one horse, aren't we, Winx? And she just strode past us behind. We'll get some vision of her now. I'll just get my cameraman to pan over to her. But there she is walking out. It's our first look at her this preparation. We haven't seen her since her fourth historic win in the Cox Plate. We're good friends off the field. We've actually practiced a couple of times together, and then when the teams came out, we were against each other. So now we are frenemies, aren't we? But you know, it should be a lot of fun, and I'm really looking forward to it. I mean, it's one of those days where I'm just happy to be involved in the polo. There's some retired racehorses, which is really important to see their careers after racing, and just looking forward to bashing Jess up on the field.
Ooh! I'm afraid Poetic Charmer, probably without you on,
maybe that's a big year.
Well, I've already had one of his owners saying, if I don't pick it from the yard.
Oh, there you go. Yeah. No pressure.
Yes. No pressure. Well, thank you so much for listening to us, and thanks for your company. Have a wonderful evening.
He's got such a terrific following as well. We saw some of the people here before with their Happy Clapper t-shirts on. He's got almost as big a following as Winx does.
I sold him them T-shirts, Lizzie. Do you want one?
I'd love one.
$5.50.
All right, no worries. We'll get one after. Well, he looks fantastic. Good luck to you and the team, and I'll be cheering on the clapper for sure.
Thanks, Lizzie.